Hey, art family, if you like this one, the full-length version is on Patreon.
They are skidful.
Hello, art family. For this squash demonstration, I decided to do the American blue lobster at the Pittsburgh Aquarium at the zoo. Before I get into doing the actual demonstration and talking about it, I decided to talk for a minute about materials and my kind of current suggestions. If you want to just skip straight to the demo, it's at 3 minutes and 30 seconds. So I get a lot of questions on Instagram and Twitter and on here about the palettes I use and the materials I use for gouache. For a long time I used this palette that I handmade. I learned a lot of gouache through the artist Pixel P. Chan, and he uses this 24 well box, and Lena Rivo also uses it, and so I made a palette to fit it in so that I could kind of carry it around. If you watch my How to Make Palettes video, you can sort of put together how I made this one. It's aluminum sheet from Home Depot, so it's not soldered together, it's just like metal bond glued, and then I sprayed the inside with white spray paint and clear coat. If I continue to use this, I'll probably put some cut acrylic in it from the hardware store and spray paint the bottom white so that's a little harder and sturdier. But you know, I've actually found it a little bit cumbersome, to be honest, and this is a kind of a change in my more recent gouache sketching, as I've started just carrying these old tins that I've had from watercolor, and I'll cut the flap off usually so it's a little more sturdy, and I'll just use these until they rust out. On my actual desk for demonstrations, a lot of times I use this. It's another watercolor palette that I took the inside out. I kind of got tired of putting gouache in wells, and I've more recently started just carrying a couple tubes of color, about six colors, and I'll just put it on a wet paper towel. And you probably waste more gouache that way, but I try to be careful about not using too much at a time. But that's kind of more current. And then as for travel, I carry my gouache supplies in this. I really like the chiral brushes, and here's another little tin that I've been using. It's starting to rust out though in the hinges and stuff. But I'll carry six tubes around. I found when I was carrying around, lugging around the big 24 well thing, you know, you can't tip it over. You can't really let it fully dry because it'll chalk up and fall out. And I find that I was not really using any of the colors but six colors. So I decided to sort of simplify my gouache life and just start carrying around six tubes at a time. And I'll change them out sometimes, but for the most part, I just keep a limited palette. I start off my sketch, as I always do in the other videos, by knocking away the white of the paper. And sometimes I do this with a sort of method or an idea of a general placement of things. Sometimes I'll get the drawing halfway there by doing this, using the blues as the kind of darker value and a yellow ochre as the lighter value area, and sort of just block in the general composition. For this one, you know, I didn't really care. I wasn't really concerned. You know, the water was generally sort of green. The lobster was very, very blue, very light in some areas. And I just sort of put down a kind of general blend from warm to cool. I drew this a little more than I usually do. I've kind of gotten really into, I don't know if you've noticed in the progression of these videos, since the Halloween one, I've gotten really into drawing with the paintbrush instead of using a pencil. I've pretty much stopped using a pencil altogether and gone to just drawing with a brush. I use a pencil with watercolor though, but I'm thinking about changing it because I like the kind of calligraphic line you get with drawing with a brush. I've had a lot of fun just drawing with a paintbrush, and usually I try to block in the major shapes, but I kind of got really into the sort of, you know, alien quality of this lobster and sort of got carried away with the drawing and You know, I was having fun doing it, so why not keep going? I tried to pitch the paint that I used to draw the lobster, sort of pinkish purple, but to keep it as pink as possible, because one thing I wanted to have was a very hot pocket of really bright coloration in a very cool object. So since the lobster is very cool blue, I thought it would give a nice kind of vibration and interest to the object to have just these tiny peppered bits of pink here and there. And you know, you can plan that kind of thing and lose it and you know, and it just fall apart when you just go right over your drawing. But I was trying to get little kisses of a hot red. For the background, it's mostly kind of a green with some very warm yellow ochre areas, and I'm trying not to use any white in those areas, in the light areas. I'm trying to reserve the white for the areas that I want to pop forward, and because white can be a tricky thing because it tends to cool things down, and I'm trying to hold off using white until much later on. First, I want to get as many of the big shapes as I can down and sort of build the structure of the image before I start using white to try to build out the form. As I'm painting, I'm always thinking in two ways. I'm either chiseling the form out, or I'm using the flat brush to sort of pull across the surface of the form to give kind of a sculpt to the form. Right now I'm focusing on chiseling out the form, and I can correct the drawing using this sort of chiseling method, and I can add to the drawing, add major shapes, but I'm focused on the big areas and just chiseling out with the big fat brush. That's a 1-inch chiral brush I'm using now. I'm using a little bit of white and yellow ochre to develop the bottom planes of the lobster. One thing that was very interesting, and I haven't really stared at lobsters ever, certainly not this close to notice, but there's a very translucent quality to their shell. And so you get a whole lot of rich glowing colors, and because it was blue, you get a lot of these rich teals and yellow ochres and raw siennas that are happening throughout, especially in the thinner parts, like around the legs and the joinery where the elbow or the pieces where it joins together. But you get a lot of yellow ochre in the underplanes, a lot of really warm light, because we have this lobster is spotlit from above, and it's bouncing off those yellow ochre-y kind of rocks, and it's shooting all that light into the underside, which is white. And so you're getting some really rich yellow ochres and a very, very warm glow on the bottom of the lobster. I'm trying to build the shadow now. My main focus is to get the major shapes that will communicate the sort of story of what I'm trying to show here. So I'm getting in that darker shadow on the back end that's still going to have a lot of saturation. It has a lot of little pockets of very intense saturation of blue. And I'm trying to soften those edges as I curl around the form. One thing I'm having to be conscious of is it's a very textured form. There's all these little speckles of light blue and white. So I'm trying to be conscious of that and use a drier brush to pull and scrape that texture across the top of the lobster. When I'm dealing with these lighter areas, one thing that helps, because it's very difficult to use a light color because it takes so much white, because white gets mucked up very quickly, very easily. So it's good to try to get a nice big pool of a color that you're going to use in a lot of different areas, and then try to pepper that color around and use as much of it as you can so you don't have to try to remix colors for different areas. So now I'm using some white with a little yellow ochre to kind of pepper in this textured rock pattern, and also to sort of feather and get that sort of gouache-y, feathery, soft edge around the lobster. There's a lot of hard edges, and it was sort of generalizing the interest, and I want to really draw that focus in on the head and that elbow and claw in the foreground element. So I'm trying to subdue everything else by softening those edges and also softening the intensity of the value relationships so that the strongest value relationships take place in the area at the most interest. At this point, I'm happy with the overall structure of the image and the sort of story that is trying to be told here. And so I've switched from the 1-inch flat to a size 8 round brush, and I'm just getting in those darker spots, the occlusion shadows where light can't get to. And I'm using that to sort of texture the area around to communicate the sense of rocks. and also get in these little details, the sort of orb where the eye is, and these strong lights on the kind of pointed areas underneath the head of the lobster, and then these tines that stick out. They're very alien looking when you really look close at them. I'm trying to build the structure of the elbow now because I notice that it's off from the actual image. If you look, the drawing is incorrect. I'm off by a little bit, so I'm trying to increase the size of that elbow, but I'm too far to really care about whether or not it's accurate, and my goal wasn't really to duplicate the photograph. I'm just trying to give the sense of this object. I'm adding in highlights, and I'm careful with the highlights in the areas of interest, but areas like the top of the knee, that top plane, I'm not really concerned with the accuracy. I'm just trying to sort of make that plane noticeable. Just the rough cut of this plane, and then one facing away from the light, and one catching that glowing light bouncing off the ground. I felt like the shadow areas were a little bit flat, so I'm trying to get in that curve of the form by adding a lightness to it just to communicate the roundness there. And now I'm going in with a glaze. It's a little bit bold because you could mess up the areas with if there's too much water, but I'm glazing in a darker area on top because I really want to push that sort of god light that the spotlight's creating, because it really adds focus and kind of implied importance to the object of interest. Well, that's going to be it for this demonstration of a gouache sketch of a American blue lobster at the Pittsburgh Zoo and Aquarium. I hope you got a lot out of it. If you're interested, there's a full-length version of this sketch on Patreon for anyone who's a dollar or more. Thank you, everyone, for your continued kindness and support, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. In the meantime, happy sketching.